Happy Monday, everybody. What I want to talk about today is our relationship with money. For whatever reason, we all seem to have a really bad relationship with money. And I'm guilty of this, like most people I know. I have some really great influences in my life who always seem to kind of pop up when I say something negative about money. And they say to me, you know, Craig, you've got to change conversation you have about money, and you've got to change your way of dealing with money, and most importantly, get that dialogue correct when you talk about money. And I've done a course before called The Joy of Money, and I have a very good friend who constantly reminds me how important it is to really believe that you deserve the money, and that you say the right things to attract money in your life. In fact, to be a magnet for money. So I've done this Joy of Money course before, and it really did speak some truths, but it didn't really like apply it enough. And truthfully, I've let myself get in a situation in my 40s where I'm still living paycheck to paycheck. And even though I think I'm doing the right things about money, I sometimes seem to sabotage myself and land up in really difficult situations. I've now making a commitment that I am going to love money, and that money loves me, and that I'm going to get stupidly rich. And so while I'm not rich right now, I'm not sitting here going, oh, I've had all the success, which is how most of the videos that I see and most things I ever read about and people that I talk to about have already made it. And so I get it, it's easy for them. They've got the money in the bank, so it's very easy to preach. I'm going, I got nothing. And yet I still believe I deserve money. And I'm tired of struggling, and I'm making a commitment to do something about it. I'm listening to a book called You Are a Badass at Making Money by Jen Sincere. And she's just got a way of talking about all of this that's resonating with me. The thing that I wanted to cover today, because there's a lot to cover and I haven't finished the book yet, but I know that I'm making a real effort to really work with this time. And so the first thing that she really talks to you about is this things we tell ourselves and the negative associations that we have with money. From the earliest time that I can remember, I remember one of my mom's doctor friends saying to me that you're either going to be a starving artist or you're going to have to go out there and prostitute your talent. And I've lived with that, and I've said that a million times to myself, and I have certainly, I believe, lived that way. Unfortunately, we all have these limiting beliefs, which are programmed in us over a lifetime. And I think it's time to get rid of these and to allow yourself to attract what you deserve by saying, you know what? I can be stupidly rich and still enjoy my talent. I have this belief that the creative industry that I've been in, people don't make money because everyone around me doesn't seem to have money and everyone complains about money. I'm not going to let that be my reality anymore. I also have this thing that, oh, well, I'm a designer and that's all I do. And I've got to then do specifically what I'm doing. I'm now saying, you know what? I'm open to whatever opportunities. My reality that I want is to be happy, to be abundant, to be wealthy, to be able to do amazing things for the people I love and for myself. And I deserve money. So I'm open now. Now I'm going to start getting very clear on my goals, and I'm going to start attracting money into my life. I'm sure you're sitting there chuckling right now going, yeah, but you know, you haven't done it and this all sounds like mumbo jumbo. It's okay. You don't have to believe. There's more for me then. I believe everybody deserves an abundance of everything. So by all means, follow what I'm saying, and by all means, don't. it doesn't really faze me either way. What I do want to say is that as creatives, we make a lot of excuses as to why we can't make money, that our industry just doesn't allow people to make money, that you'd have to own your own business, that you would have to be a certain level of executive. Well, I've been that level of executive and I still didn't attract the money and good fortune that I should have had. So in my mind, there's definitely something I'm doing wrong. I take responsibility for it. It's time to try something new and I'm going to. So the first thing I'm gonna do is get it out of my head that I will be poor by being creative. I'm going to be rich by being creative. And you know what? That means lots of money. Lots of money, why not? It affords me the opportunity to do whatever I like. I do what I do as a designer because it's the chosen career that I've gone into based on where I could use my skills and what opportunities were out there for me. But it's a limiting belief. I would love to spend my life on a beach, surfing, in a studio, creating sculptures, furniture, painting, who knows? But I can't do that right now because I'm going, and I have to stick to a job. I'm now saying I'm open to whatever comes my way. This is where I want to be. This is what's going to make me happy, and I'm going to truly believe in it, and I'm truly going to work on it to make it my reality. I deserve money. You deserve money. We can all live abundantly. I hope that gives you a little Monday motivation, a little money motivation this Monday, and I hope you have a great week. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, like, leave a comment, and stay cool.